You would have thought that a longer antenna performed better. In fact, I've got... So this is... It's a Wi-Fi antenna. That's very long. That's just not... It's not one wire going up there. There'll be lots of these inside it, all stacked together with coils and little things. That's not quite what I want to talk about tonight, though. What we're going to do is I'm going to explain, from everything I've heard and done over the years, what happens when we make antennas longer and still get a match, okay? Now, look, I'm going to use a piece of software here, but when I'm using the software, I'm going to race through it. If you want to go through it slowly, you'll have to hit the pause button and go frame at a time, because I'm just going to go whoosh, probably. I don't know yet. It depends on how I edit it. So let's do two things. We'll do a straight vertical and we'll do a straight dipole. Then we'll take the vertical and we'll make it longer. Then we'll take the dipole and make it longer. Then we'll make the dipole extremely long. And then we're going to get an... Excuse me, I bumped to the camera, the microphone. Then we're going to get an end fed and we'll make that extremely long. Just see what happens, because there's some fascinating... If you've got the space, some really kinky things you can do with a bit of rope. No, there's some really interesting things you can do with long wires, all right? Very long wires. So I'm just going to quickly make a vertical, let's say for 40 metres, okay? All right, I've made a vertical and I've got an SWR of 1.36. That's probably best. Let's just have a look at the far field plot. If we can picture what this might look like. Okay, so the plot on the left, we're not that interested really. It's looking down plan view. The one on the right is our elevation view. And that will change, if you like, by the sea. It will be a lot, you'll get more gain. I can quickly do that for you. By the sea, 5,000 millisiemens per meter start. You can see we get this huge gain really low down. Okay, anyway, we're not here to do that. What I'm here to do, let's go back to 50, or is it 5? Average ground, all right? Average ground where you grow your potatoes. Calculate. Right. We're just going to come down 5 degrees off the horizon. Just give us a little baseline on something. 5 degrees says minus 4.7. I'm going to write that down. I'm just going to write that down. Minus 4.7. Just so we don't forget. Dipoles and verticals resonate on every other harmonic, every odd harmonic, whatever. Which means you can take 7.2 and you can multiply it by 3, which would be 21.6. Thereabouts, a few things happen, height above ground, mucks that up. But effectively, this will also be resonant on, let's just for the sake of maths do 21.5. It says it's perfect at 21.8. In the real world, that will be actually about 21.55, 21.6. But in terms of software, I'm just going to do 21.8, just to keep the numbers happy, okay? Interesting note here. Do you notice how a three-quarter wave gives us a better match to 50 ohms, if we go right to the bottom here, than a quarter wave? We just get a better match, all right? SWR is 1.08. Just interesting. So the far field plot looks like that. Again, on our average ground, I don't know, 16 radials or something. And you can see that our energy is going kind of up at 45 degrees sort of thing, you know. However, if we come down low 5 degrees off the horizon, where before we were having minus 4.7, we've now got, so that was a quarter wave. A three-quarter wave is now minus 3.1. So depending on how you cook the books on a few things, you can get one or two extra dB with a three-quarter wave. By the way, this would resonate on three-quarter waves, also resonate on 1.25, okay? So we'd have to multiply our 7.2. So I'm going to fire up my calculator. 7 times 3, 4, 5 now. It would be next resonant on 35 megahertz. It would just be interesting on 35... ish, it's going to be 35, back to 36 megahertz would be 1.25. It says the SWR is a tiny bit wrong here. SWR 30, it says 36.5. Okay, 36.5. Not far out, yeah? Start. And there's the plot at 1.25 wavelengths. All right? So you see these lobes have gone way up high. There is a little bit of going down here. It says minus 5 point something, whatever. Not that good. And last one we'll do is we'll just move up the, get my calculator back out, and let's do 7.2 megahertz times 7. So that'll be 1.75. All right. Yeah. 50.4, it says. So that'll be about 51, won't it? Not far off. And by the way, it'd be a shame it's not 50.15, because we a 40 meter element would give you a tune then on 15 meters and 6. It will tune, you just hit the ATU, but it's about, normally, because I've tried this, it's about a 2:1 SWR. It's just a bit high. Anyway, I'm waffling. Far field plot. The reason why it would be really cool is at 1.25, you start getting these big lobes off here, which is quite usual between 20 degrees off the horizon and, you know, a couple of degrees off the horizon. If we look at our 5-degree business, which was there, it says 0.6. So very interesting. We started off at minus 4.7, minus 3.1. 1.25 wasn't very good. This is 1.75. Anyway, so that's the vertical. What happens if we do the same thing with a dipole? So let me just shut up a minute and I'll draw a dipole. So I've just drawn a dipole. It's flat at the moment, it's just sitting on the ground, but we'll raise it up. I mean, what sort of height? You guess, what number? Sort of 25 feet? I don't know, what's that, about 8 meters, something like that. Give or take. 7.2. We're starting on 40 meter band again. Do we fix the error of the... It says it's resonant at 7.1. All right, well, we'll just keep the numbers happy. 7 megahertz. SWR is 1.22. All right, so we're interested in these far field plots again, aren't we? So just an interesting plot. How do you read this? It looks like a bubble of RF, by the way, and if it's sort of 500 miles away, that's going to be about 35 degrees off the horizon, and we will see at 35 degrees off the horizon, off one end, you know, we're getting 4.8 bananas, and off here we're getting 0.6. So north, south, or east, west, there's about 5 or 6 dB. Barely perceptibly noticeable on an S9 signal. One would be S8, one would be S9. All right, so, but it looks fine. We can press a really cool button here, actually, and just see. I'll zoom it in a bit, and we can just see what it looks like. Oh, yes, very nice. Bubble of RF. So I wouldn't be too worried about its north, south, east, west, and whatever, because a low-to-the-ground dipole on 40 metres basically gives most of your gain going straight up in the air. Okay? So great on a Saturday morning if you just want to talk to your mates a couple of hundred miles away. That will work a treat. Then we go up to 15 metres again. Let's see what happens again. Remember, we're going to go very long in a minute. So we'll go to 21.3-ish. I don't know where this is resonant at. Okay, so we'll go to 15 metres. That will be resonant actually about 21.8. We'll see. SWR 2.281. Not bad. Because we've got an impedance here, I can see it. It says 111 ohms. But whatever, let's go to the far field plot. So we've got this weird looking clover leaf going on. Well, sort of a six leaf clover, I think. We're more interested in DX on 15 meters, and that will be probably around about the 5 degrees mark. So let's have a look over there. It's a minus 0.9, minus 0.4. 0.8 there, we've got some dips going on. So we get this funny thing, and if we fire this thing up here so you can see what it's doing, it's quite an interesting pattern. So there's a 3/4 wave. So if you had like balance line into big long doublet, what's going to happen? Well, let's go even higher up. If you remember, the next one was about 36.5. something like that. So that would be a 1¼ wavelengths. SWR's not bad, so that'll do fine. What happens now? We get more of these fingers. So we've got our antenna is actually running on this plot north-south, and we can see we're starting to get these north-south lobes here. We'll go 5 degrees off the horizon. Where is the DX? Very healthy DX. Very healthy indeed in 4 directions. Okay. And then I seem to remember we go 1¾, which was 51, 52-ish, megahertz. Let me just check where the SWR is correct there. 51.1. There we are. 51.1. We'll just have a look at what the far field plot looks like there. So this is maybe an 80-meter doublet on roughly the 10-meter band. There we are. So these fingers, in my opinion, are starting to come closer together. But again, we'd be using this, let's say, on 6 meters or 10 meters if it was twice as long for the 80-meter band. Just reduce everything, roughly 5 degrees off the horizon. Yeah, we're getting these very healthy lobes here. What does that look like in 3D, as a matter of interest? I don't know if you can see that very well. Just fascinating, really, isn't it? So this is an antenna that's basically too long. All right, so we've done the dipole, we've done the vertical, and we've made them a bit longer. And we can, what we can do is we're now going to make a very long antenna. So I had now Rowley ZL1BQD in his previous QTH, previous location, he's in New Zealand. He noticed there was a very long telephone wire going for, I don't know, a couple of miles or something. Rowley might come on, leave a comment, and I'll pin it to the top and he'll tell us more about it there. But he did have this very long antenna. Well, he converted it because it wasn't connected to anything. So he connected it, I don't know, probably with some sort of like a 64-to-1 transformer. I don't know what he did. But basically, he made this very long end fed. And he was saying he could hear and have two-way communications with stations like in America and stuff, which his friends didn't believe he was actually talking to them. But he was. He was getting a healthy signal. And it was a very long, like a 2-mile thing. I spoke to a guy on 80 metres a couple of years ago, and he had, I think it was 2 kilometres of wire, not very high off the ground, just through the trees, with some big, you know, tensioning elastic things. He genuinely did. And he told me that he could talk to this guy in Canada every night of the week on 80 metres. So he gave me all the dimensions. So I modelled it. But I couldn't, on QRZ, his email was bounced or something, so he never got my results. But I will just do this for you. So we'll make an incredibly long antenna. So let me shut up and I'll do that. Okay, so this is our X and Y. I've made this along the X, left, right, east, west axis. It's 2,000 metres, one leg, and 2,000 metres, another leg. Oh, let's go to 80 metres. Now, you could walk a mile that way and a mile that way and start chopping bits and tune it for a coax, you know. However, easiest way of running this would be some balance line to a big fat tuner, in my opinion. But whatever, okay? Let's just hit the start button, see what happens. Might take a while because it's an enormous... Even though I've got a super fast machine, there's a lot of calculations. So let me shut up and let's run this calculation. Okay, we're done. So yeah, we'd need to trim it. We've got a big high SWR. And I've put this at 8 meters high. So, but assuming we could get a tune and you could use your big fat tuner or whatever else, let's see what this does. Well, this is why he was talking to the guy in wherever he was. Well, these look very, very high off the ground. Let's just do this at 5 degrees off the horizon. Okay, so it splits in two. We've got a super high piece gain there, 16.4 dBi, which is an enormous amount of power. Put your 100 watts in there, you'd soon know it. In fact, we could do that now. Let's just quickly do 16. So you've got 100 watts. If we had 100 watts, we've got 16 dBi, so... 1,000 watts, 10 dB is equivalent to 1,000 watts. 13 dBi is equivalent to 2,000 watts. And 14, 16 dBi is equivalent to 4,000. Okay, so, yeah. Yeah, 16 is a lot, okay? It's a lot. So if you've got a 0 dB gain antenna, fairly low to the ground horizon, fairly low to the ground dipole, 8 metres, versus this guy, your 100 watts is the same as his 4,000 watts in that direction, which is probably the only reason he could speak to, you know, Quebec or something. it might have been lucky. That could have been Florida from us, because they're slightly different angles. Fascinating. Now, we've all got an end-fed knocking around, haven't we? A little end-fed. So let's just quickly model a really long end-fed before I go. This would be a very long, low to the ground, end-fed, inverted L. Okay, for some reason I can't get a match. Let's ignore the match, all right? I'm not actually that interested in the match. I mean, I've got 90 to 1 SWR here. I could probably get a better match if I hit this button here. Somewhere it's going to be resonant. I just don't know where. Yeah, it is further up. So we would have to go out and cut bits off and add bits, whatever else. It doesn't matter, okay? I'm just going to say on top band, 1.9-ish megahertz. What does the far field plot look like on a very long whole wavelength? Well, it looks like this. That's fine. So interesting, isn't it? So let's go up. Let's miss 80 because I just think we're going to get a couple more lobes. But let's go up to 7.2, whatever, megahertz and have a look at that. And look at the far field plot. So we can see we got more of these coming up now. Elevation 5 degrees. Any DX potential? Oh, there is a little bit. So we're, you know, from there to there, which is a nice big spread, we're averaging zero, okay? If you remember, our quarter wave gave us minus 4.7. So that's quite nice. There it is. What about on 20 metres? 14.3. It might take a bit of while. Far field plots. Ah, we can see in the direction of the L, we've got at 5 degrees off horizon, a couple of little lobes here, look. Nice. It's about 10 dB more than a vertical, look. Very good indeed. And, well, what happens then if we make it super long? Okay, that's going minus 16 to minus 320 metres of wire. What the hell would happen? Okay, far field plot, please. Ooh, fascinating. Fascinating. 5 degrees. Look at this. I'm looking at this gain, these gain figures up here. So there we are. Very long antenna. It's quite interesting. If you've got the space or a fence line with a neighbour, try a long end-fed. You might be surprised. Who knows? I'm going to give it a go. All right, so stick with the programme. If you follow this channel, then within a month or so, we're going to put a big long end-fed and see if we can get a little bit more gain to the US on 40 metres, particularly on a receive. Might be nice, mightn't it? So, enjoy your radio. I'll see you next time. Bye for now.